Hello everyone, this is Fresh Bagel, and I'm going to do Let's Play Joe Gunn. What the heck is Joe Gunn, you might ask? Joe Gunn is a Commodore 64 game. Now, the Commodore 64, of course, was a home computer system that was very popular during the 1980s. However, this game came out in 2007. Why? I guess the people who made it, Jörg Rottensteiner, Howard Kistler, Paul Pridham, and Thomas E. Peterson, wanted to give themselves a challenge and just decide, hey, let's try programming something for the Commodore 64. And they came out with Joe Gunn. It is an exploration platformer. It was released in English and German. And there are actually multiple versions of it. There's Joe Gunn, the original. Joe Gunn Gold, which is the version I have here. And then there's Joe Gunn Gold Edition, which makes things very confusing. The Gold Edition, you had to pay money for, but Joe Gunn Gold, you can get for free. There are a couple differences. This is what the title screen looks like for just the regular Joe Gunn and Joe Gunn Gold. I think if you get Gold Edition, you get a much cooler looking kind of Indiana Jones type of guy on the screen with some pyramids in the background. To play this, I'm using, of course, a Commodore 64 emulator. The one I'm using is CCS64. I like it because you can, I just found it to be a little bit more user-friendly. You do have to, normally you'd play the game with a joystick, but I have to use the keyboard. And in that, you have to go into the options menu, choose input. And in here, I think if we've got control port 1, mode, key set 2. It's all very confusing, but if you go down to define joystick key set, this is set to joystick key set 1. You're using the keypad, and the fire button is what's important, which on my key is the Z key, or if you're American, Z key. So let's get out of here. Whoops. So we get off this screen by pressing Z, or Z. And we can listen to some opening music, which you can listen to in your own time. And of course, you'll eventually get some little keyboard controls here. But hey, let's just jump right into the game. Finally, this must be it. The Lost Tomb of the Crocodile King. And this screen is called The Entrance, so there are my arrow keys. Now if I just press the Z key, the fire button, nothing happens, because you use it in combination with other things. So if I hold, right now I'm holding it down. Now if I press the left arrow key, I jump left, we'll come back here later, and if I press right, we jump right. But there are two other things you can do with it. Now here's a skeleton, of course. Now if I press Z, and then, I'm holding down Z, and if I press the down arrow key, you found an item, Scarab. Z down is basically search where you're standing, so you see nothing special. We have to jump over these spikes, climb up the ladder. Z down, you see an empty socket. Okay, so what do we do? Now we do hold down Z and press the up arrow key. Use an item scrub. Now, actually, if I keep on pressing up or down, it'll just scroll through my inventory, and my inventory only has one thing in it, so I can only choose Scarab or do nothing. So I will choose Scarab, and hey, the door disappears. Hidden switch. Now, these bats show up in the game. You can't kill them. They kind of move around randomly. They're very annoying. The hidden switch, kind of a giveaway. Oh, you can sort of jump over two bricks. That's as far as we can jump. Ah, we click something and the door on the right has disappeared, but let's go exploring a little bit more. See nothing special. Now, if you hold down, if you jump towards the wall here, you can climb up it like that. You can also jump at the wall from a further distance, I think. Does it work from this distance away? No, one more. There we go. You have to experiment a bit. How about this door? I cannot read this. These are hieroglyphs. Fine. And we will come in here. And this room has three different exits, so it's kind of a crossroom. This bat actually follows a precise path. It just goes up and down. It's much nicer when the bats do that. But we are going to head off to the right. I'm doing mainly a straight walkthrough here. I've played this game a lot. Now here there's a whole bunch of skeletons on the ground. Why? Well... Ah! Actually, you can fall amazing distances and not be hurt. So that's okay. Now I believe if we come back in here, the room resets itself. Yes, it does. How to get through this room is not to step on the middle of the bricks, but to step halfway along the bricks and just sort of jump your way across like so. What's this? An empty socket. Empty sockets require the scarab. You hear rumbling. Now this has affected something not in this room. We'll get to that a bit later. But there's this little notch on the right wall, and whenever you see little notches like that, that's usually a game design of way of telling you, hey, maybe there's something here. So we're going to go in there. Ooh, what do you know? Snakes. Now, we don't really have a way of dealing with snakes at the moment, so I'm going to go down here. And actually, I'm going to save. Free saved. This game does not actually have a save state. That was part of the emulator. And it's a cheat, but I like it. And you have to be careful with snakes, because they move along and then they pause suddenly. But one touch and you're dead. Now, I can look at this to see nothing special. I'm going to do something here which is a little bit dangerous, which is why I saved the game. Or saved the game state, rather. Usually you come back here once you've got something to deal with the snakes. I don't, but the timing here is very difficult. That skeleton over there has something I need, and I have to... Okay, you found an item, water seal. Okay, get the hell out. And if we look at this skeleton, you found an item, Rosetta Tablet. It's very easy to get the Rosetta Tablet here, but to get the water seal on the left, you usually need something to protect you from snakes. So I just kind of cheated there. But I'd rather not walk all the way back here later. Now let's fall down. Anything in the skeleton? No. Well, this looks interesting. You find an item, Golden Mask. And actually, you'll see at the bottom, we now have a little symbol that says 01. We found one Golden Mask. Whoops. And there is nothing in these skeletons. Back to the left we go. Fall down. Nothing here. Wait for the bat to go away. Go away, bat! Alright, now this is a huge room to start exploring. There's a little sort of door there, floating on a little platform, but how do we get to it? Well, we'll figure that out later. You can actually jump off ladders. So we're gonna do that, like so. You can also jump back onto them. And we'll go to the right here briefly. And there's a bat flying around. Now notice those symbols up there? We have an Ankh, and... I don't know what that is. It always looks, to me, it always looks like a little reclining human being under some lines. Oh, yes, but we have the Rosetta Stone now, and that means we can read hieroglyphs. So if we do Z and down, heed the signs. So remember that. Ankh, Ankh, little crouching guy. And while we're at it, I should have done this before, let's go back up and... This is a problem with the game. You can fall long distances and then have to backtrack. I am going to be cutting the video as we play, because there's some sequences that are just, you know, I don't want to take up your time just walking across huge parts of this game. There are about 75 rooms altogether. Oh, shit. See what I mean? Which is why I cut the game, so we can get back here very quickly. You'll also notice the music kept on playing smoothly. That's because I cheated. I have a new microphone. It's a really nice microphone. It's a condenser microphone. But the game... I still can't balance my microphone volume and the game volume. And the game's music, if I did it the normal way you're supposed to record, would out-volume my voice. So what I've done is I've recorded this Let's Play just with my voice, and then I've separately recorded the game's music, laid it on back over. There are points in the game where the music changes, and I'll also change the music then appropriately, so that's a bit of a cheat, but it's the best I could do under the circumstances. Right, let's look at this door. No, not use an item. First four, then one. Okay, that is a hint. That will come in useful later, kind of. And if we act fast enough, we may just make this. Yes! Alright. So, remember we had Heed the Signs in here, but now we're going to go down this ladder. Down, down, down. This door says, "Death shall come on swift rings." Well, no, it won't. That's just standard practice. Oh, remember when we used that scarab up in that trap room upstairs? What that did, there was a door here, and that door is now gone. So we basically opened that door. And all it does is it leads into this large chamber, the servant graves. And, I mean, you can search everywhere here, but Anubis embraced their souls. The only thing in here is on the upper right. And you have to search, I think, at the head of this sarcophagus. You found an item, scepter. Let's get back out of here. And we never have to go in there again. And now we're going to drop all the way down. This door says, "Hail Ra! Ra is our father!" And what do you know? Here are signs. Now, when it said here, heed the signs, remember we had Ankh Ankh, sort of crouching guy. So really, it's only the middle one that's off here. So again, oh yeah, so now we have Water Seal, Rosetta Tablet, Scepter. If, you know, and we can scroll either way. So we'll use Scarab. Nope. There we go. And that has done something up where we saw the signs originally, but we aren't going back there just yet. Throne room. Let's keep going up. We're in this area. I forget, is there something here? You see nothing special. If we head to the left here, girded corridor, and there's a guy, mummy, coming towards us with a stick, and we have no ways of defending ourselves. But we will later. But here we just take a quick jog to the right. There's a skeleton. You found an item, a crowbar. The crowbar is very important. Most items in the game have a use. Now, remember there's that door down there that we can't reach. Look above the door, you know, up to the bricks, and underneath the bricks there's the shadow of the bricks, and you'll notice that the shadow of those bricks is a little thicker than, say, the shadow under the bricks on the other parts of the screen, and that's actually, a hint. You have to jump over there, that if we press up, hey, we can actually crawl along this. It's sort of a handhold here. And we can drop down. Look at this door, and it says, "Music can be the key." But the key to what? We'll find out later. Back down we go. To the throne room. And we have to climb up here. Look at this guy. He's not going to kill us. Anything about this door? No. How about this guy? You see the hands are empty. Well, we have a scepter. So let's use the scepter. And this ladder appears. Excellent. Down we go. And here's another door. Beware the power of the book. Dun dun dun. What, this book? Yes. You found an item. Book of the Dead. A very powerful item. Now, remember we had that little passage off to the right where we found the Rosetta Tablet? This is a game where you have to explore everywhere. And what do you know? There is actually a hidden exit if you climb or jump up this wall. It's just that kind of game. Now, note this corridor that we're passing underneath. We're going to be coming back this way later in the game. Okay, this is a dead end. What's this altar here? You found an item, Earth Seal! So now we have the Water Seal, we have the Earth Seal. You might notice a trend. Now we have to go all the way back. Yep, climb up here. And I'm just gonna cut this. And now we're back here. Jump off the ladder. Go back to this room. And now there's this passage on the right that didn't exist there before. And now it's Indiana Jones time. We have this boulder coming towards us, but it's pretty easy to avoid. The next screen, however, you have to be kind of on your toes, because immediately there's a boulder coming right towards you, and you have to jump over this gap. Now, if you're playing the original Joe Gunn, there is no wall here. Actually, if you examine, you see an iron grid. And that caused a bit of a problem. It's possible to get stuck in the game. So what they did is they inserted this wall because you need the crowbar past this point. So in the Joe Gunn Gold edition of the game, I used the crowbar, bent the grid open, and you're through. And this is called the shaft. And here we have a golden mask. So now I have two golden masks. And we're going to jump down this shaft in the next video. So, see you then.